Yo, what's the deal, good people? It's your boy, Eric Taylor, Taylor to Astrology. And it's time to start a new series for 2023. Happy New Year. Hope you're ready to enjoy an amazing year on my channel from Taylor to Astrology. All right. So this is the asteroid Juno through all 12 signs. And currently in transit is in Pisces, so we're going to start in Pisces, the fish, right? Associated with the 12th house, mutable water sign. Let's first discuss what is Juno. Juno in Greek mythology was Jupiter's wife, right? It's associated with long-term relationships and marriage. So in a compatibility chart or in a love relationship chart, Juno is a very important place to look in the natal chart, because it will show the sign in the house of the desired relationship, marriage, and commitment that you want. It's got kind of a Libra Scorpio, but mainly Scorpio energy. It's about intimacy and deep connection, very committed love, okay? So when you have Jupiter in the sign of Pisces, what's Pisces? Come on, you should know this. But in case you don't, I'm happy to explain it to you, right? Pisces, like I said, the mutable water sign, is ruled by the planet Jupiter and the co-ruler, the modern ruler, Neptune, okay? Pisces are very compassionate, empathetic, spiritual, creative, great imaginations. Yes, they're often kind of in the dream world and fantasies and the fog. You know, it's associated with that subconscious mind. And these people are really, let's just be honest, they're like in 4D or 5D, they're magical. So when it comes to a committed love and relationship, whether you have the Juno in Pisces or your partner has it, they do want the fantasy and the dream, but surprisingly so, as a water sign, yes, they can be sensitive and emotional, but they want something that's very true. They're not about settling. They can be a little idealistic and unrealistic at times. And they can, I don't want to say deceive themselves or lie to themselves, but they are really wearing those rose-colored glasses when it comes to the relationship. But for them, there is a lot of private intimacy that they don't mind sharing outside as well. So there's a lot of hand touching. They're affectionate, okay? Holding hands in the theater, at a restaurant, walking down the street in public. They love to kiss, okay? Think of Venus and Pisces, like that agape Christ-like love. And they've got like the hugest hearts. Remember Pisces, wherever it is in the natal birth chart, it absorbs all the signs, the energies of all the signs, you know, prior to it. They don't want any type of deception. They're sensitive. If they think you're lying to them, they're like, time out, I'm about to bounce. Do you wanna like paint a clearer picture for me, or do I need to leave, right? This is the men and the women. The women more so than the men, but you know, Pisces and Juno, it's about a real like karmic spiritual connection. And they don't want no funny business, okay? Very sensual. I told you about the kissing, passionate. And they really want to express their love in imaginative ways, being creative. The poetry, going out dancing, let's take salsa lessons. You know, I'll write you a poem. Oh, can you write me a song? You know, let's make a song together. These people usually love a spiritual, creative type of love in general, and creativity in the bedroom. They're willing to work at it and spice it up and correct and fix things and adjust. Remember, it's mutable. So that means they're adaptable when it comes to the matters of the heart, okay? Now, you could have a different sun, a different moon. This is just your Juno. So this is a piece of the puzzle of telling the love story for your life and you and your partner, okay? This will be different if it's in the first or the fifth or the eighth house. It gets flavored in different ways. That's why you email me, tailoredtoyoucoaching@gmail.com. All right? And I do synastry, you know, compatibility charts, natal birth charts. I do it all. Juno, remember the keyword I said? It has that kind of that lovey Libra, but mainly the intense merging of the Scorpio. So for them, when it comes to Pisces, they want to trust that they can emotionally be open and get extremely vulnerable and romantic with you, okay? These people like the flowers and the chocolates. The men like if a lady gets them, you know, a tie or, you know, the tool that they need or, you know, tickets to their favorite sports team or their favorite artist in concert. You know, they want that love to be, right? It's an action, that verb, right? Show it. And they definitely like the massages and the touching and the caring. But also remember, this is very intuitive and psychic. So you don't want to get into like cheating on a Juno Pisces person. They will sense it. They will just be like, doo, 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 doo. You playing with me? Do I got to cut you? I mean, they're dope, okay? It's, but just think, right? The sculpting together, taking painting classes, painting one another. Aha. Oh, yeah. Don't be scared. So, you know, this is deep. Remember, Pisces is the deep, deep, dark oceans. So we're talking about a very sensual, emotional, like, ooh, rocking the boat type love. Yeah, Juno and Pisces. That's what we're talking about. So I hope you appreciate you having this placement and just understand in love you can be. Watch out for this. You don't want to be self-destructive. That can play out as well. I've seen that in charts of men and women. You know, it's, there can be some confusion. You wanna keep it where the relationship is protected and guarded, okay? So, Juno Pisces, hope you enjoy. This is gonna be a fun series. I might do Aquarius next or Aries, or I may just bounce around. You can comment down below. Let me know how your Juno and Pisces works for you, or if your spouse, boyfriend, or girlfriend, or partner has it. Just holla at your boy and, you know, get the birth chart done or the synastry compatibility or my mini relationship chart readings. Only $35, you know, and that's where I put Juno in there. Very important. All right, you guys. So it's 2023. It's a Neptunian Pisces year, the number 7, 2023, 2 and 2 and 3 is 7. So it's going to be very compassionate, very spiritual. And so Juno and Pisces, this is a year for you, okay? So get your love on. And comment down below. Please like, share, subscribe. Put it on your Facebook, your Twitter, you know, your Pinterest, your LinkedIn. And spread the good word. We're trying to really grow this channel even more this year. So thank you for joining me in my neck of the woods. Eric Taylor, Taylor to Astrology. All right. Bye, Juno and Pisces. Later.